Crypto products and NFTs are unregulated and can be highly risky. There may be no regulatory recourse for any loss from such transactions.
Hello?
Hello.
Huh?
Yeah, ma'am. I am calling from Beep Limited.
Okay.
Okay, you must have heard about the ETH merge.
Yes. Someone told me about that.
Okay, so I'm here to help you out regarding conversion of your ETH to ETH2.
Oh, that'll be great.
Yeah, I've sent you a link.
Okay.
You just need to click on that link and transfer your ETH to that account. And once you do that, we'll issue you new ETH2. So have you clicked on the link?
No. Wait. Done.
Hey folks, CA Rachana Ranade here, and I welcome you all to a very informative video wherein we are going to talk about two major updates in the crypto world in the year 2022. We are mainly going to focus on two things. One is the Ethereum merge, and the second one is Cardano Vasil Hard Fork. So before I move on to all these topics, first and foremost, please be aware of any fraudster calls who are asking you to transfer your ETH and you know making fake promises that they'll transfer ETH to ETH 2.0 or something like that. Please be aware of this fact that ETH still remains the same. So please don't click on any links and don't fall prey to these fraudster calls. The first major event that we are going to cover today is ETH merge. I hope everyone knows that ETH is the second largest crypto by market capitalization. Well, this ETH merge event took place on 15th of September, which will make the Ethereum network more secure, more scalable, and more sustainable. You know how fuzzing this event was? So let me tell you that even Google had featured the countdown with two pandas, and when ETH merge actually took place, that's what happened on Google. Now let's try and understand what exactly has happened in this ETH merge. Basically, there has been an upgradation in the Ethereum blockchain from proof of work to proof of stake. Let me give you a simple example for that. In proof of work, there is a competition between miners to solve cryptographic puzzles and validate the transaction, because of which there is a lot of energy which is consumed, and thus it's not environmentally friendly. But in proof of stake, there is no competition and a validator is chosen randomly. Because of this, obviously less amount of energy is required and it is more environmentally friendly. And now I'm sure you still have one question in your mind as to how can a validator be randomly chosen. So for that, the answer is very simple. More ETH you stake, the chances of you getting selected as a validator are more. And I'm sure you might be like, "Arre, this is nice. A person who stakes more ETH, that person can validate whatever he or she wants to validate." That will not happen. If such a person validates a wrong transaction, then whatever ETH that person has staked, that will be gone, that will be confiscated or lost. Well, now that you have understood the basics of proof of work and proof of stake, let me use an interesting analogy to help you explain the concept of merge in a better way. Now, assume that there is a house where they are using regular source of electricity. But then they have realized that there's a lot of energy consumption that's happening, that's not so much eco-friendly, and that is the reason why they think about introducing solar energy. Now, once they are using both these sources of energy parallelly for some time, they realize that, oh, solar energy is much more efficient and is much more environmentally friendly. That is when they take the decision to discontinue the original source and continue only with solar energy. If this is clear, then I'll now try to correlate this with proof of work and proof of stake. The original source of energy, the regular source of energy, can be compared with proof of work, which was comparatively less environmentally friendly, and the new one can be compared with proof of stake. Now, can I try to again give you a visual representation of the same thing? Answer is obviously yes. This is the Ethereum network, which was originally running only on proof of work. Then parallelly, you can see a beacon chain was introduced in December 2020, which was the energy efficient one, and then slowly and steadily they have merged into one single chain, which is nothing but working on the proof of stake. Well, I hope by now you have understood that be it regular energy or be it proof of work, that is going to be pretty costly. But what is not costly? What is absolutely free? by smashing the like button. So if you want to participate in this fascinating journey of ETH Merge, and if you wish to invest in ETH, a very simple way to do so can be with the help of CoinSwitch Kuber app. You can check out the link of this app in the description box below. But always remember that crypto falls under the high risk, high return category. So two things are very important. Number one, do your own research before you invest. And number two, invest only a party fund amount. Now let's try and understand the long-term impacts or benefits of this merge. Now, because of the shift from proof of work to proof of stake, what has happened is that whatever was the energy consumption, that will be lowered by 99.95%. In fact, after the merge took place, Vitalik Buterin, who is the co-founder of Ethereum, mentioned that the merge will reduce worldwide electricity consumption by 0.2%. The successful completion of the ETH merge will bring a major change in the fundamental functioning, and this may lead to opening more doors for adoption by more and more corporations or more and more institutions. The third one is about the lowered supply of ETH. Now, what will happen in this? Let me explain this with the help of a simulation tool. Now, if you see here, the issuance will go from 5 million ETH per year to just 0.6 million ETH per year. And because of this, what will happen is that theoretically, because the supply of ETH is reduced, ideally, the price may rise in the longer term. Now that you have understood the long-term benefits of merge, let's go back to the concept of sharding. When did I explain this? Have a look at it. Did you even notice that sharding was very much there in the entire process? So now, let me explain this concept of sharding with the help of an amazing example. This is a big road on which buses, cars, cycles, and two-wheelers pass by. However, due to the heavy flow of vehicles, there is a lot of congestion on this road. Now you can imagine that if the road is split category-wise, then wouldn't it lead to less congestion, more speed, and less energy consumption? Answer is obviously yes. So if you agree to this, and if you feel that you have understood this, it means you have understood sharding already. No? Not convinced? Let me take you back to the example. Now, instead of the highway, visualize that this is an Ethereum blockchain. Instead of vehicles, we have transactions which are to be validated on this network. However, as Ethereum network started to become more and more popular, more and more transactions were being carried out on the network, leading to congestion. Well, this is where sharding will play an important role, wherein the Ethereum blockchain will be split in such a way that the validation process will be more efficient, ultimately leading to less congestion, more transactions per second, and less transaction fees. Well, believe it or not, but after sharding takes place, it will be possible to run an Ethereum node on a laptop or even on a mobile phone, which will definitely lead to more decentralization. This sharding is expected to take place in 2023. The second major update that we are going to discuss today is about the Cardano Vasil Hard Fork. This is expected to take place on 22nd September 2022. Well, earlier it was expected to take place in June 2022, but it was postponed citing certain software and testing issues. But what exactly is this Cardano Vasil Hard Fork update? A hard fork is when participants on a blockchain network decide to split the chain, resulting in two versions of the same network or protocol. Basically, the Cardano Vasil hard fork update aims to make the network more scalable and also improve the developer's experience while they are creating dApps on the network. Also, this update is aimed to improve Plutus, which is Cardano's smart contract platform. The crypto community, all in all, I can say, is very much optimistic about this update. Now let's try and understand the long-term impacts of this update. The very first one is reduced transaction fees. Because of this new update, the transaction fees on the Cardano platform are going to be significantly lower. Secondly, it will also resolve the issue of dApp scalability. Currently, Cardano platform hosts 1,075 dApps. The third benefit is about the speed of transactions. The speed after this new upgrade is going to be significantly higher, and currently the transaction speed is 250 transactions per second. Well, if you found all these updates very interesting and if you want to be a part of the crypto world, then is there any solution for that? Answer is obviously yes. Just check out the link in the description box below and download the CoinSwitch Kuber app. With this app, you can start investing your party fund amount, or you can start with as low as 100 rupees. How can that be done? That can be done with an amazing feature of SIP. Well, if you have enjoyed this video, don't forget to share this video with your friends. And if you want to know more about what's in my portfolio, you can click here. And if you want to know more about traditional finance versus modern finance, you can click here. Till then, take care. Jai Hind and bye-bye.
Crypto products and NFTs are unregulated and can be highly risky. There may be no regulatory recourse for any loss from such transactions.